Welcome. Do you require additional supplies?
Let's see what you have.
Let's get this directorate meeting over with before we speak further. It's important.
Dr. Ayo.
Do you mind?
We're all here. I think it's time we begin.
Sir, excuse me, but what exactly is he doing here?
I will address that issue. But there are other subjects that require our attention first. The level of unrest in the Commonwealth continues to rise, as we're all aware. Your report.
All Institute facilities remain completely secure, with the exception of one notable breach. Otherwise, internally, things are as tight as they've ever been. Dr. Ayo has been keeping an eye on things topside.
Yes. Watchers show no additional threats beyond those previously identified. Boston International Airport remains occupied, with Brotherhood presence noted at several other points throughout the Commonwealth. Intelligence suggests that this railroad continues to operate and is becoming more ambitious. SRB agents are monitoring all known situations, sir.
Very good, thank you. It's clear that our safety needs to be the primary concern going forward. To that end, where are we on Phase 3?
Excuse me, but, sir, are you sure this is, well, the proper time to be discussing that? Considering, I mean, given all parties present?
Ah, yes, that's true. Have you heard anything about Phase 3?
I have no idea what that is.
I'll admit, I'm relieved. It's intended to be something of a classified project, which I'm sure means everyone already knows about it. Power is, as I'm sure you've seen above ground, a very valuable commodity. I'm not talking about some abstract concept of control. I mean real, tangible power. The kind that keeps the lights on. With every advance the Institute makes, our need for raw power increases. Many compromises and sacrifices have been made over the years to allow progress to continue.
In this world, I'm sure compromise is necessary.
Quite right. For far too long, we've been dependent on others. On our surroundings, that time is over. Phase 3 is simply the activation of a nuclear reactor that can provide enough power to the Institute now and forever. It will ensure not just our survival, but our prosperity.
Nuclear power? That's a disaster waiting to happen.
Not in our hands. I assure you, this is the answer. This is the future. The reactor is close to ready, but recent tests have determined we have a few tasks ahead of us. Thus, we come to Phase 3, and to how you will help.
Sir?
Yes, Dr. Ayo. Previously, we would rely on Kellogg for above-ground operations, yes? Well, he is gone. While I'm not overly fond of putting my own father in harm's way, he has proven more than capable of handling himself.
Yes, but...
This is not a matter for debate. Now, there is one more subject that requires discussion.
I don't know that this is the time.
Dr. Holdren, it is time. Please, as I'm sure several of you are already aware, I have been under Dr. Volkert's care for some time. I'm sorry, this is difficult for me. Our best efforts have failed. Every experimental treatment we could devise has been unsuccessful. I'm sorry to say I am dying.
No,
please, be serious.
Everyone, Please, I am sorry. This is not how I wanted to tell you, but we're running out of time.
This can't be happening. I only just found you.
I've had the same thoughts more than a few times. But we cannot let this stop us. Our work must continue. We can talk more later. Right now, the future of the Institute is at stake. The Institute cannot survive without leadership. The Directorate must continue to govern with the best interest of all in mind. To that end, I am naming my father as my successor.
Oh, boy.
You can't be serious!
Really?
How can you possibly justify this? He isn't one of us. He isn't even a scientist.
Ignoring your borderline insubordinate tone, I will simply say this. The Institute has enough scientists. What it needs is a leader. I believe my father has already proven himself more than capable in that regard. This will conclude this meeting. Thank you.
It's great to have you here.
The Institute is my life. I hope it'll be yours too.
I have some information you might want.
Okay. I'm listening.
The Brotherhood of Steel is going after something called a beryllium agitator in the ruins of the mass fusion building.
Are you kidding me? Okay, look, I'm not even going to ask how you know about this. This puts Phase 3 in jeopardy. We need to act on this now.
What's this Phase 3?
Just forget you heard anything about that, okay? You're our primary above-ground operative, so I need you on this. I'll contact Fillmore and give her a heads up. You need to go meet her right now, okay? Now. This is serious.
Let your surroundings be a reminder of what science and willpower can accomplish.
I had no idea.
I know this is... well, it's a lot to take in at once. I'm sorry, Father. I hope it wasn't too presumptuous of me to put you in charge without even asking first.
I can do the job.
Of course you can. That's why I made the decision. There are hard decisions ahead for all of us, but for you especially. I know that you'll do the right thing.
Thank you. was coming. I don't understand why you're acting this way. Don't tell me to calm down, Carl. When we started designing the beryllium agitator, you said it would be for the benefit of mankind. Instead, I find out that you have been planning on turning it over to the military all along. You lied to me. Don't give me that high and mighty attitude. Have you picked up a newspaper lately? There's a war going on out there, Doctor. And if our side's going to win, it needs all the help it can get. I can't believe what I'm hearing. Since when did science start taking sides? What did they promise you, Carl? Money? Political favors? A goddamn medal? That's enough! Like it or not, when the testing cycle is complete, I'm crating up the agitator and sending it off to Washington. Now, you have two choices. Either you can get back to work, or you can get the hell out of my building.
Security's too good.
Thank you.
check that out.
Thank you. Dr. Ingram?
Amazing that this tower is still standing. Hope it stays that way while we're here.
Got it.
Radiation levels are dangerously high in there. Let me know if you need any radiation protection. I'll communicate with you through their intercom system while I monitor everything from out here.
Now cycling airlock. Please wait. Initiating decontamination sequence. Decontamination complete. You may proceed.
Agitator should be in a port at the top of the reactor.
Thank you.
Excuse me, Proctor Ingram.
Glad to see you're still in one piece.
I wouldn't have made it without your help.
That's funny. I seem to remember having to talk you into letting me come along. Anyway, we shouldn't stand around here talking. We've got a lot of work to do. Well, this is it. Moment of truth. We've pre-programmed Liberty Prime's battle coordinates into his navigational processor. As soon as he's under his own power, he'll head straight for the Institute. Elder Maxson wants you to follow, and make sure he arrives at the CIT in one piece. I've checked every wire and every bolt on the big guy. All we need to do is plug in the agitator, start Prime's reactor, and cross our fingers.
Did you fill up his tank and check the tire pressure, too?
You're a real comedian. Anyone ever tell you that? Look, I discussed it with Elder Maxson, and we think you should be the one who has the honor of starting Liberty Prime. Just plug the beryllium agitator into his reactor port, then head back down here and press the transfer button. Good luck, Paladin. Ad Victorium. Look, I'm really busy, and I'm not in the mood for talking.